The Honourable Member for Wolseley.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Two years ago, during the election, where was the promise from the Conservative Party in Manitoba to all Manitobans that a 20% salary increase for our Premier and a 20% salary increase for every Cabinet Minister was going to be more important than sustaining funding to public transit? Will the Minister responsible for transit cuts, the Minister for Municipal Affairs, please answer that question?
The Honourable Minister of Municipal Relations.
Well, thank you, Madam Speaker, and it's just a true pleasure to stand up today on the second year anniversary of forming government. Madam Speaker, we are very proud of our investments in transit. As a matter of fact, we're so proud of the investments we make, Madam Speaker. We're continuing on with bus rapid transit, Madam Speaker, to ensure that those programs continue on for the betterment of Manitobans, Madam Speaker.
The Honourable Member for Wolseley on a supplementary question.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Where was the Conservative Party of Manitoba's promise to Manitobans that that minister's salary, the Premier's salary, all of the Cabinet Minister's salaries were going to be so important that they had to be a priority, but a carbon tax was going to be introduced and assigned to the very same public transit services that he just stood up and claimed to be supporting? Will the Minister please answer that question?
The Honourable Minister of Municipal Relations.
Well, thank you very much, Madam Speaker. And again, I can't reiterate, maybe I'll make it more clear for the member opposite. I mean, the bottom line is, Madam Speaker, we are communicating with our municipal partners, including the City of Winnipeg. We are focused on what's best for Manitobans, Madam Speaker. Unlike members opposite, we'll make sure we get it right, Madam Speaker.
The Honourable Member for Wolseley on a final supplementary.
If the Minister wants to get it right, he need only look to this morning when the local president for the Amalgamated Transit Users and myself and representative from Functional Transit gave this government a perfect opportunity to, for once, work with others productively and do the right thing. Will his government provide a no-interest loan to all municipal transit authorities who want one so they can get electric buses, save money, reduce fares, reduce emissions, and create local jobs here in Manitoba? Promise I could get behind.
The Honourable Minister of Municipal Relations.
Well, thank you, Madam Speaker. And I'm glad the member opposite brought up this morning. I just wanted to share with the House what a lovely morning we had with my colleague, Minister Cox, when we shared information.
I would just remind all members that when referring to members in the House, that they be referred to by their ministerial portfolio name.
The member from River East and I, we were at an event this morning, Madam Speaker, introducing the new Heritage Trust, and we actually were looking, we had an excellent morning with the Winnipeg Foundation, Madam Speaker, and I can tell you that those organizations, museums and archives, are so thrilled to have the open dialogue and communication with our government, Madam Speaker. Again, Madam Speaker, where they got it wrong, we'll get it right. Yeah.